thank God and acknowledge God, the Lord Savior Jesus Christ, for just allowing us to be at least intuitive enough to stay together. When things, you know, kind of fell apart in a lot of places, and we didn't have a lot of answers, had more questions than answers as far as where we would go in life, let alone this music industry, we managed to have the wisdom and understanding to know that we're better off together than we are apart. And it's paid off. And this is probably one of the proudest moments of my life. I'd like to also acknowledge my mother, Nathan's mother, my wife, Sharonda, my son, Ty, who is here, all of my good friends and family who have come to share this occasion. I mean, the beautiful thing about this is that some of these people I haven't seen in about 10, 15 years, and it's even deeper than the star itself. It brought true love and true friendship back together. And this is a great, great, great moment. And I would like to also send a spiritual shout out to Mr. Khalil Roundtree, who was our first role manager and somewhat of a father figure to us. And I know he's looking down, smiling, with his big chains on and his big cigar. And this is just I can't explain how happy I am. This is one of the happiest days of my life. I thank all of our fans who we affectionately call them soldiers. We thank you so much for being here, and for those of you who are there in spirit and everything. We thank you so very much. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Wow. I concur with Sean. God is definitely good. He blessed us with the understanding that we needed to bless the world with the gift that he gave us, and that's the gift of music, the gift of song. A lot of people don't know what goes into, you know, recording a Boyz II Men song, but if you're looking at us right now and you can see straight through us, you can see that our hearts bleed music. We do this for one reason and one reason only, and that's because we love it. And we love to be recognized for the music that we give. I mean, it's the best feeling in the world to even be able to, 20 years later, be standing here in front of everybody and being appreciated, which means that we did our jobs, and the job that we did is memorable. I want to thank everybody that's been a part of our lives for 20 years, those who are distant and rooting for us, those who are here and fighting for us, everyone who came out to bless us with their presence. This is an incredible situation, and you know, we're going to take it just like we take everything else, and that's like a blessing. Khalil Roundtree, he was not just like a father. My dad, he sent me on the road when I was 15 years old, and the only way that he felt comfortable was because Khalil was with us, and he is not ever. It's not a day that goes by that we don't think about him. Mr. Michael Bivins, I was a dude from the projects. You know, I was eating $1.25 sandwiches and quarter juices, you know what I'm saying? And the opportunity, the friendship, the brotherhood, the prowess, the vision, all of those things are just looked at and I admire it, and I look to in the future be able to hopefully do the same thing for other artists. My brothers, man, Nate, Sean, and Mike, we've been through a lot, man, and the ups and downs are crazy, you know, but the beautiful thing about being here right now, is that I know that these guys feel the same way that I do about music, about love, and about God. And that right there is what binds us. That's the tie that binds us. And as long as, I say this all the time, as long as there's good, real music in the world, Boyz II Men will do our best to reach deep down in our souls and give that to you to the best of our abilities. If we mess up every now and then, please forgive us. Everybody does. But if we're successful and continue to be successful, we ask that you root for us, because we are trying and definitely pushing forward to be the ambassadors of real music, real love songs, and just artists all around the world who want to express themselves with an artistic value. I want to thank our families, our kids, our friends, and everybody that's here. We really appreciate you. Thank you.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? First and foremost, I would like to thank our Lord and Christ, the Savior, Jesus Christ, man. Without him, I promise you, none of this would be possible. And if you don't know him, please get to know him. Accept him into your hearts today, please. Because trust me, there is a God. Seeing the four of us on stage today after 20 years, there's a God. You know, just being able to breathe and be up here, there's a God, man. So please just acknowledge that God. I would like to now acknowledge our parents, man. You know, we love you guys so much, man. I haven't seen, wow. I haven't seen Mama Gail in so long, man. I have not seen Ms. Stockman, Mama Stockman, nobody in so long, man. But I do love you guys, man. Don't ever get that confused. I love you so much. You know that. To see Biv, man, Quadri, E. Safi, Bab, Jimmy and Jim, man, Terry Lewis, man. Oh, my God. And all of our friends and family out here today, man. Wow. Trust me, I'm going to smile for the rest of the year. I'm going to smile. I'm just going to wake up every day. I promise you. You think I'm joking? I send you a picture every day on the email. I promise you. I mean, really, man. This is a true blessing, man. To be up here with my three brothers back here. Man, I love you guys, man. I love you guys, man. Don't ever get it twisted. I love you guys. So y'all know it, man. I'm a 40-year-old dude telling three other dudes I love y'all. So that's love. So God bless y'all, man. I'm gonna pass the mic over to Mr. Nathan Barnes.
I had a bunch of people ask me how you're supposed to feel today. Are you excited? And I didn't really know what to feel, because this has never really happened for me or for my guys before. I'm one that's used to situations. I like to know what I'm getting into before I get into it, and this is undiscovered territory for me. And I don't really know what to say. I just know that 20 years ago, there were people in my life that decided to make choices. And this is when I was young and didn't really know the choices to make myself. And Mom thought it was important for me to do music. And I was young, didn't know any better. Eventually, I wanted to play football, do something else. My mom and I'm sorry.
Take your time, brother.
I want to acknowledge two people that are very important to my life and my group, because if they didn't walk me down the right path, none of us would be here today. I brought my grade school music teacher and my middle school music teacher to stand up. And if it wasn't for them, none of us would even be out here today. They passed us on to high school, to Mike Bivens, all the Motown people that are here today, everybody that's just been there for us. And as you get older, you realize life is about choices. And you guys made a choice to come out here today and be a part of this. And everybody out here has made a choice some kind of way to be a part of Boyz II Men. And We appreciate it from the bottom of our hearts.